Hey, good morning, grade six. Sorry, I took a little beat there to figure out what was going on there. I got my cat here playing with my shirt. Here we go. Get this cat off here. Homework, linking verbs, subjects and complements. Subjects and complements. Let's look at this. This is quite an elaborate homework assignment, but you have a few days to do it. Linking verbs and subject complements go hand in hand. You can't have one without the other. Our goal with this assignment is to identify linking verbs, learn how they work, and see how they affect the sentence. Your assignment comes in two parts. First, the worksheets, and then the sentence diagrams. Here's a general overview of linking verbs. You're welcome to look at that or look at your vocabulary post for vocabulary test 9. There's information there about linking verbs. There's also a wonderful post here that tells you more about linking verbs than you'll ever want to know. But basically, they're different than direct objects. They can have nouns after the verb, but they use linking verbs to connect a descriptive adjective or a descriptive noun to the subject. Now the difference is with a direct object, you have the subject doing something to somebody. This subject isn't doing anything. It just is smart. These paper towels aren't doing anything. We're just being told that they really aren't towels at all. So there isn't anything happening in the examples above. There's no action. The verbs are either connecting adjectives or descriptive nouns to the subject. For more information, see this post. What you're going to turn in to me? You're going to turn in the completed worksheets and a separate sheet of paper with sentences diagrammed as directed. Your sentences for diagramming are below here. Your worksheets are here. You do not have to print the worksheets to complete them. You can just use a separate sheet of paper. If you do, please indicate your answers clearly. If there's any confusion about an answer, it will be marked incorrect. So we click here, and that'll bring up our worksheets. They look like this, linking verbs. Number two is predicate nominatives. And number three is predicate adjectives. Predicate adjectives and predicate nominatives are both types of subject complements. They're both types of subject complements. One uses nouns to complement the subject. The other one uses adjectives to complement the subject. This is an example. If I'm going back to the post, adjectives to complement the subject. Terry is smart. Smart's not a noun. Paper towels aren't really towels at all. A noun to complement the subject. All right. I'm going to go back to the... Here we go. Let's go back to the first one, linking verbs. So on the first part of this, all you're going to do is underline the linking verbs. The only thing you need to be careful about are verb phrases. Okay? Verb phrases. What we're looking to do is have a subject connected with an adjective or a noun on the other side. In between will be the linking verb. Warren is somebody's name, and Warren was sick. Was is my linking verb. Bradley's mother, mother's my subject. What is she? An air traffic controller. That's an example of a predicate nominative. Is my linking verb. Remember, has been. That's a verb phrase. Here's one of our modal verbs. Be careful. I see a linking verb after that. So just underline the verbs in those sentences. Make sure you do not screw up those verb phrases. In the second part, you're just going to underline the verb and tell me whether it is an action verb or a linking verb. If something's happening in the sentence, it's an action verb. If something's not happening in the sentence, it's just giving a subject complement, and then it would be a linking verb. One way that I figure out if something is a linking verb is I ask myself, can I put the verb is in place of the verb in the sentence? If I look at this particular sentence, now all these are linking verbs, all right? 1 through 10 are all linking verbs. If I can replace the verb, in this case here's the verb phrase, have grown. If I can replace it with a form of the verb to be, in this case I am weary of television. The verbs, the sentence still works. I am weary of television. Was is a form of to be, so that doesn't work. Here is an is a form of to be, already done. Are is a form of to be. How about this one? Jamie is uncomfortable on the stage. The sentence still works, right? Linking verb, verb phrase, complement. She is late every day this week. How about the sky is cloudy until late afternoon? How about this carton of milk is sour? You see how all these linking verbs can simply be replaced with is? That's how I know I have a verb phrase complement. You are hungry after all that work. The top-ranked player in tennis is, or there is. So if we look at number 11, my grandfather received the Congressional Medal of Honor. My grandfather is, this is not a linking verb. This is an action verb. I am is a form of the verb to be. She, my grandmother, seems young to me. My grandmother is young to me. I would underline seems, the verb, and tell myself that is a linking verb because I can say my grandmother is young to me. It's a linking verb. Jeanette found a picture of her grandparents. Found, can I take that out and put in is? Jeanette is a picture? No, that is a transitive verb, and we have what she find a picture, direct object. Do that for those. So what you're doing in those sentences, just finding the verb and telling us whether it's an action verb or a linking verb. Find the verb. Tell us whether it's an action verb or a linking verb. Action verb or linking verb. And the second part, predicate nominatives. All you're doing is finding the verb and then underlining it and underlining the predicate nominative twice. So our verb is became and our predicate nominative. What did Alaska become? Alaska is a state. Stamp collecting was my grandmother's hobby. What is the verb was? That's the verb, okay? So stamp collecting was what? A hobby, not my grandmother. So hobby is my subject complement. In this case, it's a predicate nominative. The scorers, highest scorers in the game were Lucy and she. Scores is my subject. What were the scorers? Lucy and she. We have a compound subject complement. Credible journey is what? A book. LaToya is what? A gardener. Is your cousin a mechanic? Your cousin is what? Mechanic. Mechanic is my subject complement. See how these work? The two goalies this season are Juan and he. Goalies are Juan and he. That's my subject complement. Compound subject complement Juan and he. Second part. You're going to tell us whether we have a direct object, whether we have a predicate nominative, or whether it is neither of the above. So we've done several vocabulary challenges so far. We've done direct objects, we've done indirect objects, and we've done verb phrase complements, and then a couple compound subjects, compound verbs. When we find out if something is a direct object, we always say, has something been verbed in this sentence? Today, we, the subject, watched what? A movie. That's a direct object. That's a DO. Your wet clothes are in the dryer. Now, though we do not have a direct object here, that does not necessarily mean we have a predicate nominative. In the dryer is a prepositional phrase. If I have a prepositional phrase directly after the verb, I have a verb phrase complement. In this case, it is neither a direct object nor a predicate nominative. It is a verb phrase complement, and you will answer N for that one. The rest of them, you figure out on your own. Predicate adjectives. In this case, you're going to do kind of the same thing as you did in the previous one. You're going to underline the verb and then find the predicate adjective, which is the same as a predicate nominative, except for instead of a noun describing the subject, it's an adjective describing the subject. The director seemed what? Content. That's an adjective that's describing the director. We felt, what did we feel? Proud and happy. That's my predicate adjective, compound predicate adjective describing the subject we. The corn was delicious. The corn is my subject. It was what? It was delicious. Delicious is an adjective describing the corn. There's one hard one in here I found. Let's see where it was. At first, the puppy seemed, what do you seem, healthy and energetic? That's an easy one. Gumbo tastes what? Spicy. Navajo blanket is what? Is beautiful. These are all pretty easy, guys. You shouldn't have any problems with them. This next part's easier than anything. All you're telling me is whether the underlined word is a predicate adjective or a predicate nominative. They're all subject complements. They're all linked to the subject with a simple linking verb, and they're telling us something about the country, something about the subject. And so you're just telling me whether that's a PA, predicate adjective, or PN, predicate nominative or noun. Country's a noun, so it'll be PN. Long is an adjective, so it will be PA. finish the rest of these. It's a no problem situation for you, I'm sure. I'm going to go back to the post, trying to keep this short and sweet as I can. Sentences for diagramming. These sentences all come from the worksheets, so I suggest doing the worksheets first as they will provide you with most of these answers. You must only diagram the simple subject, the simple predicate, verb or verb phrase, and the subject complement. So Elm is my subject, is my verb, tree is my subject complement. That's all you're going to be diagramming. Alaska, became, state. That's all you're going to be diagramming. Collecting, was, hobby. That's all you're going to be diagramming. These other things are telling us about hobby, or telling us about collecting, or telling us about, this goes with became in 1959, a state. So diagram the simple subject, the simple predicate, and the subject complement, and you will be golden. Let me know if you have any questions. Please put your questions in the comment box below. I'll be happy to answer them. I do ask that you refer to a specific page, either by page number or by the title of the page, predicate adjectives, and then tell me the number of the question that you have. If you'd like, you can write the whole sentence, but just tell me what you're trying to find. You're trying to find the linking verb, you're trying to find the predicate nominative. What are you trying to do? And as long as I know what your question is, I should have no problem answering you. That's all I have for that. Please put your questions below. I hope you have a wonderful evening. Masalema.